were some reports of people getting COVID-19 not once, but twice. So is herd immunity even possible with coronavirus?
Yeah, so those reports, there are reports of that happening. It doesn't seem to be that common. There are a few reports, but it's kind of hard to tell how many people will re-get it, since a fairly low percentage overall have known to be infected with the virus. So the chances of getting it twice might be kind of slim, but the reports of people getting infected twice are pretty rare. In the next, I think, several months, we're going to have a better idea of how many people, how long immunity lasts against the virus once you've had it and gotten over it. And it's an area of active investigation. There's some studies that have shown that immune responses may not be as strong after people are sick as we would like, but those studies haven't looked into all the arms of the immune response. So it's still an open question, unfortunately.
Sweden veered toward herd immunity as a strategy. It didn't really work. So what went wrong there, and what can we learn?
Well, I mean, it's a good question. It's a complicated question, because Sweden has had some issues, but they've also done better than other countries in Europe. Depending on, you know, so not as, they've had more issues than Scandinavia, but not as many issues as some other countries in Europe. So it's complicated. A lot of it has to do with the density of the population. I mean, how people tend to congregate, weather patterns, healthcare systems, testing. It's very, very difficult. I think the hope is that eventually that people will have, you know, herd immunity, and usually the ones you have to watch for are those individuals that are sick, underlying health conditions, or the elderly. And so the goal is to try to stop the spread to them. I think it's very, very complicated. I'd love to give you a straight answer, but, you know, different places have done different things, and some things have worked in some places that haven't in others. And there's a lot of variables in this, unfortunately.
Misinformation has been a major challenge for the public health community in this pandemic. Where should people look for the most reliable information about this disease?
That's a great question. And, you know, part of the problem is sometimes scientists, health officials, doctors, we talk about the knowledge that we have at the moment. And when it's something new, sometimes we don't have all the information. And sometimes we're wrong, and sometimes we don't like to admit it. And then sometimes people are honest, saying, look, you know, 3 months ago, this was the information that we had, and we did the best we could with it. We've found out more information now, and so now we're adapting to the new information that we have. And then just by admitting that we're learning as we go, because this is completely new, I think that would, you know, really helps communication, so that people can realize, look, you know, hey, we did, you know, several months ago, we weren't encouraging people to wear masks because there wasn't enough disease out there. Now that it's a lot more prevalent, now we're moving towards masks. And I think it's important for people like myself to kind of explain why that shift has happened. And for everyone just to be open-minded and realize that everyone, you know, is trying to do, healthcare professionals, we're trying to do the best that we can with the information that we have. And as we learn more things, then we can give better information. I like to look at multiple sources to try to get the information that I have. So if you want to look at, you know, the spread of the disease and what's in your community, there's a couple of resources. Johns Hopkins has a great interactive map. The New Mexico Department of Health does a great job of breaking it down by county and infection at different time points. And then overall, I think guidelines by the CDC and WHO, and they're changing their guidelines as we learn more, but that's a good place to get some information as well. There's a lot of things that are mentioned in the news, and they will always say this hasn't been peer reviewed yet. And what that means is someone came up with a finding and they are talking about it, but it hasn't gone, it hasn't been vetted through the scientific community yet. And so that's always something to keep in mind too. It's like, okay, well, this is an interesting finding, but it hasn't really been confirmed by other scientists yet. If you hear something that's been published or confirmed by multiple different groups, that always gives you a little more comfort that, okay, other people are able to repeat this in different situations. So there's a lot of places to look, but I think it kind of depends on what you're looking for. And just for people to realize that Everyone's trying to work with, the best they can with the new virus, and we're all trying to basically get better at the information we give as time goes on. And I think just people understanding that could lead to a little more understanding of you know, when what we're trying to do right as we get more information.